single day. Rosal, what a voice. I love sitting at your feet every single day. The only thing God does in the Bible is speak. He talks. Everything God accomplishes, He accomplishes through His mouth. And He gave us a mouth to do what He does. He said, the mouth of the upright shall deliver them. God rules His universe through conversation. God rules His universe through conversation. His mouth is the creative force. He spoke His word. Daniel said, He spoke and I was strengthened. Your success is determined by the voice you trust. If I know who you trust, I can predict your decisions. And decisions decide success. Remember, success is the obtaining of a worthwhile goal. Wisdom is the ability to see difference, recognize difference. Difference in people. Difference in a countenance. Difference in an environment. Difference in an opportunity. Difference in right and wrong. An evil man and a righteous man. Success is not a divine decision. It's a divine desire. It's not a divine decision. You said, Mike, God is in control of everything. If He was, why are there rapes? God doesn't control rapes and murderers. God has given us 331 times in Scripture. He gave us the opportunity to make a decision. Isaiah 1:17 says, learn to do well. If success was merely destiny, then it doesn't require me. But He said, learn to do well. And then verse 19, He says, if, and He says it 331 times in the Bible, if I'm willing and obedient, I shall eat the good of the land. The voice I honor is the voice that controls my life. The voice I honor. Stroke your Bible again. Say, I love this word. It's healing my mind. Correcting my goals. Making me wiser than my enemies. Multiplying my faith. Now kiss your Bible. Don't you love kissing the Word? Oh, I sleep with this Bible. Say it, I love His wisdom. Oh, I love His wisdom. The psalmist said, I love Thy law. Your favor is like sunrise, driving all my nights away. All my nights away, I love sitting at your feet every single day. Yes, yes, yes. I love sitting at your feet every single day. Let's pray this prayer aloud together. Holy Spirit, You are my master mentor. You are my trusted teacher. I love Your law. I'm addicted to Your voice. When You speak, I listen. When You correct me, I change. When You instruct me, I obey. Tonight, I am a receiver. I receive Your blood. I receive the cross. I receive Your word. I receive Your advice. I receive your wisdom. I receive any instruction. I am a receiver. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. Praise God. You may be seated. Turn to Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 7. Does that surprise you? No. Proverbs 4 and verse 7. So blessed us. Thank you. Thank you for your joy. Thank you for your countenance. Thank you for your faithfulness. And what's this song? Keliah? Keliah. What's that? What's those words? How'd you say it? Keliah, Keliah. What? How do you say it? Say that again. Keliah? What does that mean? Praise the Lord? Wow. Sounds a lot better than that, those words, than just praise the Lord. That's electrifying. I started to ask Pastor what that meant, and I didn't want him to know how stupid I was. So I just thought I'd wait and ask. I love that song. Wow. And who's the brother that was dancing over here? Where's he at? Brother, you have four legs and four arms and I've never seen so much movement in my life. He would be on television every day in America for sure. Yes. I think that's supernatural myself. I think that's supernatural. Beautiful, beautiful. I felt like the Lord was getting great pleasure out of that. Great pleasure out of that. We've got a wonderful God. A wonderful God. There's many parts of God. Nobody knows all of God, just a touch. God's like a library and He gives us a page. There's too much to God to know all of God. And every man has a different experience with God. And the experience we have with God becomes our message to people. The experience we have with God becomes our message to people. Oral Roberts had tuberculosis and stuttered when he was 17 years old. He was dying. And God healed him, and that became his message to people. The God you discover, the God you learn about, the God you know about. This is why we need each other. I may have an experience with God that you have not had. You have an experience with God that I have not had. And this is why we need each other. What part of God have you discovered? Tonight, I feel released in my spirit to share my personal testimony of the part of God that I discovered. My father did not discover that part of God, but he knew more about God than anyone I knew, and he's the most righteous man I've ever known in my whole lifetime, most pure-hearted man. Never known a man pure-hearted than my father. Man who prayed 4 to 10 hours a day, but the part of God that I discovered was different than his. And so we share when God begins to touch our life and reveal himself to us. And we have nothing apart from him. He is our life. He is our life. We've covered many things this week. We covered things such as to write your goals down. That when you write a goal down, you increase the chances of obtaining it 90 times. 90 times. When you write a goal, God said, write your vision down. Make it so plain that whoever sees it will get excited and energized. We talked about turning those goals into pictures. That if you wrote down, I want a new car, find a picture of the car. Put it on the wall at your house. We talked about The importance of not letting your house just become a museum of yesterday. But there should be at least one wall at your house. I call mine the dream wall. If you have an extra room, call it the tomorrow room and pictures of the future. There should be one room at your house with pictures of the future you intend to experience. You create your experiences. You decide what you want to experience, and you can only do something you can see. In the world of your imagination or your life, this is why I go through maybe 30 or 40 magazines a week, and I tear out pictures of things that inspire me, because it's my responsibility to find what inspires me and put it in front of me 24 hours a day. God works with dreamers. God works with dreamers. God looks for men who excite him, that have goals that require faith, goals that require God. We talked about the importance of writing down your goals and keeping the people in your environment informed about them, because only 3 people out of 100 have ever written down their goals. In America, that's 3% of Americans own as much real estate as the other 97%. 3% of Americans have as much money as the other 97% combined. 3% write down their goals. To get you into the top level of life, you have to set some goals. Something you want to become. Something you want to do. Something you want to have. Almost nothing is more important than seeing a goal. We talked about the difference between the person of Jesus and his principles. That a relationship with God is different than his laws. You can experience God in a moment but not know his laws. That God loving me has nothing to do with my money. God loving me does not increase my money. Me loving God does not increase my money. And I have to have money. So he gave us his laws, and obedience to his laws produce prosperity. The person of Jesus creates your peace. His principles create your prosperity. The person of Jesus prepares you for eternity. His principles prepare you to live on the earth. He was never taught the laws of increase, and there are laws. Psalms 112, 1, 2, and 3 says, a man that loves the law of God, the commandments of God, the statutes of God, wealth and riches would be in his house. And we know that because God honors obedience with prosperity, that he has a passion for us to prosper. He said, if you being evil know how to give gifts to your children, how much more does your heavenly Father want to give gifts to you? God is authorized by faith. The activities of God are controlled by faith. Faith in us. And God said, without faith, it's impossible to pleasure God. We talked about the importance of faith because God does not respond to tears. He sees them, but he does not respond. God does not just respond to our pain. God doesn't respond to disease. He responds to faith. We have shared how the most important scripture in your Bible is Numbers 23:19. Faith comes inside me when I hear God talk. Faith comes when I read something God would say. Faith comes when someone tells me something God would say. God's word contain faith, energy, strength. The only battle Satan really